everyone, welcome to the video series of the subject Object Oriented Programming using Java. Myself Hema Disha, I'm working as an assistant professor in LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. In this video lecture, I'm going to cover the topic class path and static import concept of unit number 4, package and exception handling. This topic is a part of package concept. Now, we have already done with what is package, how to create the package, how to use the classes which are available inside the package, what is the import keyword, how to import the class and how to use the properties of class. Now, we have done one program in which we have created one package, UNI and DEPT packages. This package hierarchy we have created. And one department class we have created in this package. Now we have stored this package in this D drive OOPJ programs folder. And we had access this department class from this use of department.java file. And this file is also we have saved on in the same directory OOPJ programs folder. Now in this case, your package directory and your file where you are accessing the package both are in the same directory. In this case, you will never get the error. Now think about this way. We are just moving our package, UNI package, DEPT package in this department.java file in some another location in your computer. I'm moving this package inside some other drive, E drive, OOPJ package folder, and in this folder I am putting my this package UNI, then DEPT, then department.java file. So here this whole package I am putting over E drive and this OOPJ package directory, and I am going to access this department class from the use of department.java file, which is again in some another drive and another directory in the same computer. So what will happen? Will it work or will you get the compile time error? So let's try this thing. For that, we have already created this package in D drive in previous lecture. So I am just deleting this package from D drive. And see here, there is no UNI package. Now let's create this package in E drive. Click on E drive, then click on this OOPJ package folder, and see here this class is available. This we have already created. This class we have created, right? Now let's try to compile. We have moved this package in another directory. Try to compile, move in your drive, then move in your folder, then press Java C, then space, then file name use of department, use of department dot Java. Remove the class and dot Java. See here, what we are getting? We are getting the error like this. This package UNI DEPT does not exist. And department is unknown symbol, not find the symbol. This symbol you will never get because the package that you are going to access in use of department.java file is not available in the same directory. So you have to set something in your program to compile this code. So how to solve this particular error? For that, the concept is available, accessing the package concept. The accessing of package, it basically works like this. As the package are stored in directories, how does the Java runtime system know where to look for the packages, where these packages are actually exist? So for the two ways are available, this Java runtime system or this this Java system basically search first in the current directory. It default starts searching from the current directory. If this class and package is available in the same directory, same current directory, or the subdirectory, then it will be found. You do not need to set. So our previous program works successfully. The reason behind that is it is created in the same directory. The package is created in the same directory, and the from same directory we are accessing the package. So this first way you can search the package. Now second way. So if your package and access file is not in the same directory, the second way you should use, it specifies the directory path or paths by setting the class path environment variable. One class path environment setting variable setting that you have to do in your program. For that, you must need to learn what is this class path environment variable. So this class path environment variable basically points to root directory of the system package hierarchy. Now this value of this class path environment variable used to locate the dot class file that Java tools to search. This Java C, Java, both are the tools that search from the directory which is specified as a value of this class path variable, right? Say for the example, several root of directories, if you wants to set, that means you have many packages and your packages are available in different directories or in different location, you can specify more than one path in this class path environment variable. For example, that you can use, that you can specify by using the semicolon between the values. For that, say for the example, I want to set my current directory as a searching for the searching of a package, and one new directory E drive OOPJ package for the searching of the package directory. So for that, I can concatenate this dot, then semicolon, and the E drive OOPJ package directory path. So semicolon is basically used for the concatenation that specify more than one path for the searching of the package. Now, this Java will search for the required package by looking up the subsequent directory described in this class path variable. Now, you must have the question how to set this class path. So, to set this class path, two ways are available. First, at the runtime, you can specify this path by using the option hyphen class path. This is the option that you can use at the time of running or at the time of compilation of your Java file. So here you just need to use Java C or Java, then hyphen, that means dash class path, then again press the space, then specify the path where this package is available. That means root directory of your package you have to specify. Here our UNI package is available in E drive OOPJ package, that's why the class path value I have specified. E drive OOPJ packages is my directory where my package is available. Then space, then use the class name or use the Java file name, right? So hyphen class path you can use, it is called as a tool options, by using the tool options. Now setting the class path as a system variable, that means inside the system you can set this class path value. This value you can set permanently as well as temporarily. To set the permanent value, system environment variable setting is available. I am showing this in the same video lecture. In this temporary, you can set this class path by using the command. You just need to write the command and run this command, set class path equals to the value of your package directory. Here you can write like this and just press the enter key and run this command. Your class path will be set. Now this value is temporarily, you have to set again and again whenever you wants to change it and when you wants to use it again, right? Every time you have to set. So if you are setting permanently, then this value is available as an environment system variable permanently. Though you are shutting down your machine, then also this variable value exists. So this is called the permanent setting. So in this video lecture, I am also covering how to set this permanent class path value setting also. So first, let's try by using the option. Let's try to remove the error that we are getting in our program. Use this class path environment variable by using the option. For that, here I am having the command prompt. Now type this Java C. Then hyphen class path, this is the option that you have to use. Then use the class path value e drive or packages available in e drive. Then opj packages is a root directory of our unidept folder, right? So this value you have to write. Now make a space, then use the class name o use of a dot java, use of department dot java. This is our file name. See here, now we are not getting the error. The meaning is that whenever your package is available on the different location, not in same directory, at that time you can use this option with the compilation of this code, at the time of compilation of code. For that, the option name is hyphen, or you can say the dash, then class path. Class path is an option, and after that make a space and use the directory name, right? Now this, let's try the second way. The second way to set this class path system variable, here I am setting the permanent class path. Here I am showing the permanent class path variable setting of value, permanent value setting for this particular variable. For that, open the my computer and right click on the my computer properties, then advanced system settings, select it. Now in this, click on the environment variable button, and system variable and user variable you can set inside it. Press the new button to create the variable name. Write the variable name class path. Then value you can write first current directory, that means dot, then semicolon. Now after semicolon, you have to append the lib directory of your JDK. For that, open the directory where your Java is installed. Here I have installed in C drive program files, C drive, then program files. Then here this is JDK, move in your lib directory. And from address bar, copy the path, right click, then copy the path. And set this value as an environment class path variable. After the semicolon, put this lib directory value. This is the location where built-in packages are stored. Now, I want to specify my package directory. For that, our directory is available in E drive, my computer, E drive. OPJ packages, this is the directory, root directory of our package. Copy this path and append this path after semicolon over here. So here you just put this path like this, right? And press the OK button. Here first it search in a current directory, then built-in location, then our location. Now press OK button and close all the windows by pressing the OK buttons. Now let's open. You have to restart your command prompt. If it is already open, then you have to close it and reopen it, otherwise your setting value will not get the affected, right? Will get not affected. Now this D drive OPJ folder, move in your drive, try to compile. Here I'm not using the option because class path variable already set. Just Java C, then use class name dot java, file name dot java. Here we are not getting the error, that means we can access the package. Here we are running Java, then space use of department. Here we are getting the output department number equals to 1. So that means we can access the classes which is available in different package, not in same directory, packages not in same directory, by using this system environment variable setting, class path environment variable setting. This is the permanent setting. Though you are setting down your command prompt, though you are setting down your machine, then also this value exists for that particular user for which you have set, right? Now let's try the static import. What is static import? We have already done with the import statement. So when we wants to use some classes which is available in the different package, we are using the import statement. So what is the difference between normal import and static import? The static import basically loads the static members of the class only, while normal import load each and every, that means static and non-static both members will be loaded. So here only static members will be loaded, right? So you can reduce the load if you wants to use only static members inside your program, so that you can reduce by using the syntax of static import. So here this basically use that class directly, you don't need to use the class name, you can directly access the static data member without using the class name. So it basically when you don't want to use your class qualifier name, you should use this syntax, right? To use this syntax, the basic syntax is available. After import statement, you just need to append the static modifier. Then you have to specify your package name, then class name. Here I want to use this out static variable, static data member of the system class. That's why I have used the import static java.lang.system is a class, then star I have used. That means I can access all the static members of a system class directly. So here instead of writing system.out.println, I can directly write out.println statements. Here I'm not using the class qualifier names at the time of using out, right? This is the basic things. So it basically makes your syntax short. But what is the disadvantage? When you have declared this out is not a part of this program. So here it basically reduces the readability and understandability of your program where this out comes. Whenever you are using system.out, the meaning is that this out is a static things of system class. That's why you are going to access by class name then dot operator. But here you are directly using, so you cannot get the idea where this out is basically available. So it reduces the understandability and readability of your program. So hope you people clear with the class path mechanism, when we should set the class path, how many ways to set the class path value, where we should set this class path value, and what is the use of static import concept. So here I'm going to end this session now. Thank you for watching this video. I will continue the next topic in my next video lecture. Thank you for watching it.